Hello, this is the class of Conant map, or this is also called K-map. This is a simplification method how we can use to minimize any Boolean expression. Let us start with two variable K-map. For example, if there is two input A and B and corresponding output is Y. Now we know that the combination of two input can be 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. This is the four combination that we can have with two variable A and B. Now suppose for a particular example, our Y is given as 0, 1, 1, 1. This output Y is given in the problem. So this is the expression of a particular, this is a particular truth table. Now what we need? We need to simplify this truth table. Now there is two methods. One is min term and one is max term. So in min term that we will study first. What we do? We first take only where 1 is output. That means Y we are having 1. So here we are having 1, here we are having 1, here we are having 1. So these three 1 we only take. That is called min term expression. So 0 we are having our first expression as 0. So this we are not taking. So for min term expression, we take only wherever we are having 1 as output. We are not taking the 0 as output. So what we do first, whenever there is 1, we write their expression. For example, this is 1, so we will write the expression. Now it is 0, it is 1. So 0 means it is A bar or complement of A. A complement, that is 0. So we write A bar. And this is 1. So this will be B only. That means whenever there is 0, that will be taken as complement. Whenever there is 1, that will be taken as it is. So this is A bar B. Similarly, this one is, here we are having 1, so it is A, here it is 0, so this will take as complement. So it is A B bar, as it is 1 0, so we will take it as A B bar. So this is A, this is B bar, A B bar. Now this is also 1, so we will also take this 1. So this is the output 1, so we will take the expression of A and B. Now here A is 1, B is 1, so we are taking A, B as the input because both is 1, so we don't take any complement. So this is the 3 term where we are getting 1 as output. Now second thing is we have to combine this, that is by adding, so that we can have sum of product format. Sum of product or SOP. So this is product, this is product, this is product. We have to add all of this, so it will be sum of product format, SOP. So our format is A bar B plus A B bar plus A B. This is the our expression in format of min term. So this we can write min term Boolean expression. So this is min term Boolean expression. So from truth table we we take whenever there is one in output, we write the term, we add the term in sum of product format, that is min term boolean expression. Then what we do, we write this term in the Connaught map. So how to form the Connaught map? Now here we are having two variable A and B, and both variable can have either 0 or 1. So in Connaught map, our general procedure is to write in the format of 0, 1, 3, 2, like that. 0, 1, 3, 2. Our conventional way is 0, 1, 2, 3. But there is one change, 0, 1, 3, 2. This we have to remember. But here we have only two expressions. So we can go only up to 0 and 1. If we will have another variable, more variable, then we can go up to 0, 1, 3, 2 in this format. Now, suppose we are taking A here. So first is 0, second is 1. 0 means A bar, because we take complement in case of 0. So it is A bar, that is 0, and 1 means A. So 0, 1, A bar and A. Now in this we will write B. So again it is 0, 1, 3, 2. So first 2 will only take, so it is 0, 1. So it is B bar, it is B. So 0, 1, 0, 1. That is the format A and B. This is two variable, so we are taking only A and B. Now we have to plot. We have to plot 1. We have to plot 1 whenever this term comes. Now this is the first term. So this term is A bar B. So we can see whenever A bar B comes, this is A bar. So this is the row. Now A bar B, B is this. So this is the column. So this row and this column intersect is this position. So this position is A bar B. So that is our first term, A bar B. Next our second term is A B bar. Okay. So A B bar, we have to take the intersect of row and column where A and B bar is there. So it will produce A B bar. Now this is A, this row. This is B bar, this column. So intersect is this one. So this is A B bar, our second term. First term is this one, second term is this one. Third term is A B. So this is A, this is B. So this is our third term. So three term, we have written all the three term in the K map. So this is after writing in the format of min term expression. Min term, that is sum of product format, we write all the terms in the map. After taking in the map, what we do, we combine them or we pair them or we group them in a group of, that is in number of 2, 4, 8, 16, like that. So whenever there is 2, 4, 8, 16 together, we can group them. Okay, so that is, this is blank. Now here these two easily we can group. So this is our first group, a group of 2. Now here also we can group 1. So this is our group of 2. So we are having total 2 group. One is this one, another is this one. So we are having total 2 group. From this 3 term, we are having 2 group. Now we will write what is the function of this group. Now here, both are of B. This is of A bar. This is of A. Now A and A bar, both are present in this group. In this group, A bar and A, both are present. If both are present, A bar and A, that is both the complement, that is 0 and 1, both is present. So this term will vanish. A and A bar both are present. So in this group, A this term will vanish. B is there in both cases and there is no B bar. So B will exist. So this is B. From this group, this horizontal group, what we are having? This is B bar. This is B. So in this case, B and B bar both are present here. So B is vanished from here and A is present in both the cases. No A bar is present. So A is taken at. So this group represents A. So after taking all this term in Cornut map, we have to group for a number of 2, 4, 8, 16 like that. So we have done 2 group and we have written whatever the number, whatever the expression we are having from common from this 2 group. So we are having A and we are having B. So now what we do? This is finally we have to do sum. So what is there? One is A, one is B. So that is the expression. Our output Y. So our expression is one term A, another term is B. So A plus B, that is Y. This we can get that this is the representation of addition, or we can have in term of gate. This is the format of OR gate, that is A plus B, and it is doing, so it is OR function. Now if we can recall 0 0 0 0 1, we are having 1 1 0, we are having 1 1 1, we are having 1. This is the truth table of OR gate. So this is the truth table of OR gate. This is the function of OR gate. So from the truth table of OR gate, we know that this is OR gate, but this is the steps how we can get from the truth table, how we can get the expression in simplified format. We are having 3 term, but now we are having only 2 term, and that is also simplified. Here 2 variable one term, 2 variable another term, 2 variable another term, but finally we are getting in simplified format 1 variable one term, 1 variable another term. So only 2 term we are getting and only 2 variable, 1 1 each. So A plus B, that is the simplified format. That is how we can minimize any truth table or any big function with help of Cornut map or K map, and finally we can simplify the function. Next we can apply the same Cornut map for 3 variable operation. So we'll have how 3 variable expression can be minimized with help of Cornut map. So first one is our truth table. So one truth table we are having. Suppose the 3 variable is A, B and C, that they are the input variable. And output we are having Y. So for 3 variable, what are the possible input structure we can have? They are, first one is 0 0 0, then 0 0 1, then this is highest. So we have to go to next. So it is 1 0, next is 0 1 1 0, after this 1, next is 1 0 0. Because this is separated, we have to go to 3 digits. So it is 1 0 0, next 1 0 1, next it is 1 1 0, next it is 1 1 1. So these are the possible combination for three input variable. Three variable we are having A, B, C from input. Now the output for a particular case is given, and I am writing directly. It is 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. It is given in the problem. So this Y, this we don't have to remember. This is given in the problem. What we will do? We will just simplify this. Okay. So first one is, whenever there will be 1, that we will take and we will write the term. So this we are having 1, this we are having 0, so we don't take this. This we are having 1, so we will write the term. Now it is 0, 0. 0 means complement we will take, that is bar will be there. So it is 0 for A, 0 for B. So it is A bar, B bar, and this is 1 for C, so it will be C. So A bar, B bar, C, that is the first term. Second term it is A bar, B, C bar. Whenever there is 0, we are taking bar. Whenever there is 1, we are taking as it is, the variable. Here we are also having 1, so it is 0, so we will take bar. So it is A bar, B, C. Here it is 0, the output is 0, so we will not take this one. We will take this one, which is 1. So it is 1, 0, 1. So this is A, B bar, C. A, B bar, C. B bar we are having 0, so we are taking complement. 0, we are taking B bar, that is complement. Then it is 0, we will not take. It is 1, so we will take this one. So it is A, B, C. All of them we are taking. There is no 0, so we don't take any bar. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 term corresponding to whatever we are having 1 in the output. Next, what we do? Our format is sum of product. So this is individual product format. We have to write in the format of sum. So we just write them. This is the first term. This is the second term. This is the third term. This is the fourth term. This is the fifth term. So all of them I have written with summation. So that is the sum of product format, that is min term format. Now we have to plot them. Now as we are approaching here, there are three variables. So what we can do, previously it was two variables. So we have taken one variable in each side. One side A, one side B we have taken. Now there are three variables. So what we will do, we will take two variables at one side, one variable at other side. Suppose we are taking A, B together and C another side. So A, B if we take, first one is 0. In case of two variable, it will be two digit. So for 0 it is 0, 0. So that 0, 0, that means we are taking A bar, B bar. So that is 0, 0. Next is 1. So that is 0, 1. That means A bar, B. This is 1. So 0, 1, 3, 2. That is the format I told. 0, 1, 3, 2. So 0, 0, 0, 1. So next 1, 0 will be at the last. That is here. And 1, 1 will be here. So 0, 0. 01 1110, or we can say 0 1 3 2. This is the format 0 1 3 2. Now here we are having C. The variable C we are having. Now C, just only one variable, so we can have 0 and 1 both the term, that is C complement and C. C complement is 0, C is 1. So 0, 1, that is C complement and C. Now what we do, we will write each of this term in this box. Now this term is A bar B bar C. So A bar B bar is this one, this row, and C is this column. So the intersect is A bar B bar C is this one. So whenever there is intersect, we write 1 in the box. Next is A bar B C bar. So A bar B is this one. So this row is A bar B, and with C bar, this is the column of C bar. So what is the intersect? A bar B C bar. So here we write another one, that is the intersect of this is A bar B up to this, and this is C bar. So this intersect we write 1 at the rate A bar B C bar. Next is A bar B C. So A bar B is this one and C is this one. So this is A bar B C. Next term is A B bar C. So A B bar is this one and C is this one. So this intersect we are having A B bar C, this one. And last one is A B C. So A B we are having this row, C we are having this column. So the intersect is this one. We are writing 1 at the box where it is A B C, that is it is A B and C. So this we are having the total Carnot map plotted all the terms. This is the Carnot map. So next what we do, we do one thing, we can group it in case of 2, 4, 8, 16, like that we can group. So whenever there is some combination of 2, 4, 8, 16 in this order, we can combine them. Now you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, these 4 1 are in a single column. This is a single column. So what we do, this 4 we can group. So this is 4 group, group of 4, this is group of 4. Now this is remaining. What we can do with the side, we can combine as a group of 2. This is a group of 2. Now we have to write the each, what are the term we can getting from the group. Now this is 4 term, but they are together a single group. So we will write whatever the group that is. So for this bigger group, that is this total column, what we are having? For this bigger group, that is this total column, we are having C is common for all of them. For this total column, it represents the column of C. This is the total column. So this is C. Now if we want to say that what will be the case of A and B, these two variables. Now here you see, this is A bar B bar, this is A bar B, this is A B, this is A B bar, and this is the column. So whatever we are having the combination of A and B, that is 0 0, 0 1, 1 0 and 1 1, that is 0 1 2 3, all the combination 0 0, 0 1, 1 again it is 1 0 and it is 1 1, that is 0 1 3 2. All of the combination, that is by 2 variable we can have 4 combination. All the 4 combination is combined in this group. That means the combination of A and B all the combination is present here, so we just vanish the term A and B. So we take only the term C. So this is the, this bigger column represents C. Now we have to take this smaller one. Now here we can see C bar and C. C bar and C both is present there. So C and opposite of C, C bar, both is present there. So C will vanish from here and A bar B will present here, because in this group only A bar B is the possible combination of A and B. No other combination of A B is there. So A bar B will take, C and C bar both is present there. So we just vanish this. So this is A bar B. So what is there? It is, this is our reduced expression, minimum expression, A bar B. A bar B plus C, this is why. So this is the reduced expression with three variables. Now we have completed for two variable Carnot map. We have completed for three variable Carnot map. Now we will see how it is possible to reduce four variable Carnot map. Okay, so let me first draw the input combination of four variable. So this is four variable A, B, C, D. So first we will write the combination which is possible for four variables. So this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Next, we have to go to 4 digit, that is 1, 0, 0, 0 is the lowest, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is the all possible combination which can be done by four input, that is four variable as input. Now the output, it is given. Now output, it is for a combination of gates or a bigger circuit. So this is not the output of any particular gate. This is combination of many gates. This is of a circuit. So we don't have to remember the output. It will be given. We have to only simplify the expression. Now I am directly writing this one. Output 01. 01. 0. Triple 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. This last term will be 1111. So that is the input combination, and for that our output, that is Y, it is given. Now what we have to do, we have to just simplify, and we'll start from taking the ones. Okay, so here the last two digits was, this is 1110, and finally the last will be 41. So that is the combination. So we'll take, this one is 1, so this is second, it is A bar, B bar, C bar, D. This is 1, so what we take, A bar, B bar, C, D. This one is 1, this will take, that is A bar, B, C bar, D. A bar, B, C bar, D. This one, A bar, B, C, D bar. Now this is A bar, B, C, D. This is 0 will not take, this is 1 will take, that is A, B bar, C bar, D. Next, this is 1, so we take A, B bar, C, D. Now this is 1, that is 1101, that means A, B, C bar, D. And finally at the last, that is 41 is there, so it will be A, B, C, D. So this is unsimplified Boolean expression. So whenever there is 1, we take that term, and finally we add all of them. So our final expression is just adding all these terms, that is
so
So this is all the term I have taken together to form the unsimplified Boolean expression. So unsimplified Boolean expression is this one, written in the format of sum of product or SOP or min term. Now we have to put them in the Carnot map to simplify them. Now this is the Carnot map. What we do? We first draw the plot so that we can have two variable one side and two variable other side. So 0 0 for AB we are taking as A bar B bar, that is 0. Next is 1, that is 0 1, that is A bar B. Next is 0 1 3 2. Next is AB. Next is AB bar. Similarly, we have to write in case of C and D variable also. So this is 0 0, that means 0. 0 1, that is 1. 1 1, that is equivalent is 3. This one is 1 and this one is 2. So 2 plus 1, it is 3. So CD is 3. So 0 1, 3 and 2 we have to write. So it is CD bar. So it is 2. So 0 1, 3 2. Now we have to plot all the terms in this graph. So first one is A bar B bar C bar D. So A bar B bar is this one. C bar D is this one. So this will be the place where it is A bar B C bar D. So this term is done. Next is A bar B bar C D. So it is A bar B bar and C D, this one. Next is A bar B C bar D. So A bar B and C bar D, this one. Next one is A bar B C D bar. So A bar B C D bar is this one. Next one is A bar B C D. So A bar B, this is C D. So it is A bar B C D. A bar B C D, this term is also done. Next is AB bar C bar D. So AB bar and C bar D, this one. Next is AB bar CD. So AB bar and it is CD, this one. Next is AB C bar D. So AB C bar D, this one. AB C bar D, AB C bar D, this one. Next is AB CD. So AB CD, this one. So this what we have done, we have written all the terms whenever we are getting one to the Carnot map. Next thing is how to simplify it by term of grouping 2, 4, 8, 16, like that. And one thing is there, if we can group for 4, we will not do group of 2. If we can group for 8, we will not do group of 4. That means if we can have bigger group, we will do bigger group only, because that will minimize the term. Okay. Now this 8 we can group together. So we can group like this one. So this is a bigger group having 8 component and this we can group of two, we cannot group of three, we can do group of, we can do group of two or four. So this we can do group of two. So now we have to write whatever expression we are having. Now from here all the combination of A and B is there. So A and B we vanish. Here we can see combination of C and C bar is there. So C is also vanished. D is common in both cases. So we take this as D. And this one is C and C is here. So C will be there as there is no C bar. D and D bar is there. So D will be vanished. A bar B is present. So we can write A bar B C. Just for the convention, A first, B second, C third, so that it looks good. So I write A bar B C. So our final is A bar B C plus D equal to Y. That is A bar B C plus D equal to Y. That is our final answer. That is minimized expression. That is from this much bigger truth table having various combination of inputs. Four inputs variable we are having. There are various outputs and outputs combined of 0 and 1. And finally we simplify them and having these two term only. We are having only two term. One term is A bar BC, another term is D. This is our final expression. Y is output. So this is how we can simplify what today we have learned. That if there is two variable input, three variable input, in this case four variable input, how we can minimize them with the help of Carnot map, and we can have the simplified output like this one. Thank you.